So from learning about your vast expertise as an educationist and the various activities you undertake, we as a group, the Global Classroom, also have the same dream and are like-minded people in that regard. We wish to connect people, cause empowerment and social innovation using the digital platform. So does our mentor, Mr. Santosh Talgi, the founder of the Namaskar with Love Foundation. Welcome to you too, sir.
Thank you so much, Emmy. Thank you so much.
Dr. Naidu, as we progress into this session, and as I told you that I believe we are like-minded people, all of us, as we work eventually towards the same objective. What I wanted to initially know from you is that the entire process of being a part of children's lives, education, and factors related to that, it's indeed very fulfilling, isn't it?
Yes.
So what is it that motivates you, despite all the obstacles? I believe there are many. What is it that keeps you going and has kept you going to achieve what you envisage finally?
Satisfaction.
Dr. Raidu, thank you so much for being online with us. This is probably the first time we are meeting online. We have met personally, but this is the first time. So I thought that, you know, we have every day we have some engaging sessions where we have some, you know, collaborative discussion to share the experiences, because we are in the quarantine mode now. And instead of, whose sound is coming? Whose mobile is making voice? Where? And so instead of feeling quarantine and lockdown, we felt, why not to open and be receptive to the world? And why not to, you know, share the new ideas and bring the new ideas to make remarkable impact? Because now we have understood that it is even an individual through this corona has taught us, even one person, even if he is, you know, even if the virus enters in one person, it can harm everybody. In the same way, I feel that if good thought enters in one person, it can impact on the mass. So it is not just one person or 10%. It is like we all are global representatives of this entire universe. So since you have Gurukulam and you have education system, and I could see a lot of news coverage in Pune and also in Bengaluru. And I am from Karnataka, actually. I'm a Kannada speaker. And then I have a good relation with whole, you know, the state. So I wonder now how new things can be managed. We have global classrooms and you have certain, you know, many institutions. So how do you think now the colleges are managing during the quarantine? Because it's not just a lockdown, because things should go on. And then how the new practices are coming up. You shared one beautiful article today. And even personally, day for yesterday, I saw that even CBSE has taken some new motive to engage teachers along with the students. So what kind of new experiments are happening in the Karnataka? Can you give a good light on this topic, please, with along with your experiments in your own school?
Yes. By the way, Amy and Tamanna and Santosh, my name is Dr. Venkat Raidu, and I have done my research in educational institutions and leadership. I have done my research for 20 years in 25 countries, and last 3 years back I applied for my PhD in Chowdhury Charan Singh University, and last year only got my doctorate. Wow. And I am associated with many schools and colleges as a advisor, director and consultant, and I'm working as a CEO for two schools and one software company also. I'm working as a CEO, and completely all the schools are in South India. Schools and colleges are in South India, like Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra, Telangana, and all some schools in Kerala also. Last month, I attended one conference in Coimbatore. So I am a panel member in one discussion, and there are senior most people where we are discussing about shift of technology in education, shift of technology in the education. So when will this happen? This is the question asked by the moderator. Then one senior person who came from Tirupati, he told that it will take 50 years to adopt technology in the education, what he expressed. And one more person, Mr. Krishna from Pune, he's having a group of schools. He told that, 50 years it will not take, it will take another 5 years maximum to adopt this technology and everything. And a person called Alisa from Microsoft, Bangalore, he came to that discussion and he told, nothing like that. In 1 or 2 years, completely it will be changed, what he expressed. Then it came to my turn. And I told, shift already happened because everybody is using, nowadays in India, the highest population is below 30 years. Everyone is learning through mobile. Everyone is using mobile. Everyone is attached to e-learning. And previously, in our generation, the education used to stop from 3 to 25, education is closed. Again, no one is ready to learn or anything. But now, even 70 years aged people are learning. Whether it's online or offline or however is it, the learners and became very, very high. They're also competing with the young generation and learning new things. Coming to a present situation, immediately after the lockdown, I think on Sunday they have announced a curfew or something in Karnataka, and from Monday onwards they told it's lockdown. So what I have done is I have trained all my teachers completely how to install the Zoom, how to use the Zoom. They don't know what is Zoom, all our teachers.
Yeah.
They are now... See, in the schools, what we do is immediately after coming to the school, teachers should submit the mobile in the office. And while they go to home, they should take the mobile. Yeah. We don't encourage them to maintain WhatsApp groups also. Because these ladies will discuss something and come next day with some problem that lady is talking in group like this lady is talking in group like this. So we ban the groups and even I want to send any message, I have broadcast one. Option is there. From that, I will send a message to everyone, but they are not in group. Uh-huh. So we are very strict and we don't want them to use their mobile phones. Uh-huh. Suddenly now, sir is asking to take your mobile and install Zoom and everything, they are upset. And we created immediately one group. Yeah. See, according to the situation, we should change. Otherwise, we also will become a Nokia company.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
We also will become a Nokia company, definitely.
Uh-huh.
So Tamanna, your mic is muted. You want
I saw that. It's just saying absolutely about this Nokia thing.
Yeah, we also become Nokia. I explained the same example. Now time is changed. You also should change. I also should change. Otherwise, our school will become a Nokia school. So let us start classes. So immediately we trained all the teachers how to install the Zoom, how to use the Zoom. Internally, we conducted 2 days, morning and evening meetings. And we trained the students. And next, we asked all the teachers to call the parents and ask them to install and train the parents and how to install. It took for us 3 to 4 days for all the students and all the community to all the stakeholders to adjust to the system and come into the training classes and everything. So we started the classes daily. For every student, it is like half an hour one session and half an hour one more teacher will take. Mm-hmm. We started with like magic science or something like activities or some project works or something like puzzles and all these things. Slowly, slowly we made them, we brought them into the interest. And now, from last Monday, we started our academic curriculum also. Directly, teachers are teaching maths, English, science, social, and all these subjects. Slowly, we started teaching. And the most powerful thing what we observed is, in class only, the students will be there. They can teach however they want. after going inside the class, we may see, observe them in CC camera, but what they are speaking, yeah. which language they are speaking, how they are teaching them, and what is the outcome, we don't know. They will give the notes and the children will study and everything. Here, it became a challenge for every teacher. Becoming a challenge for every teacher because they should, school teachers will not have very good English. School teachers will not have very good English. Generally, their basic degrees are MA or MSc, and they don't want to stay at home. They're all mothers and they want to pass their time, they come to school. They're not much efficient people in most of the schools. What and all the I'm not talking about all the teachers, some teachers. Now, every day we are conducting morning and evening sessions for them. They should explain before they teach in the class. They should explain in a group, Zoom room, and we are giving feedback on them. All the teachers are giving feedback on their teachings. Okay, all the teachers are giving feedback on their teaching. And in within a span of 15 days, all the teachers are speaking good English, number one. Their pronunciation, modulation, and previously what the experience of teacher is, when we are teaching on the board, we are not able to teach. Now we are going, we are showing a lot of graphics, videos, PowerPoint presentations we are making. We are preparing very strongly. We are able to teach the children, sir. Now we integrated Google classes with the Zoom. Mm-hmm. The teacher will prepare everything, presentation, everything in the Google class, and share the screen in the Zoom, and she'll talk in that. So everything is happening very excellently, and there are parents are also appreciating. Why? Because in the houses, no child will speak in English with mother and father. If they are very well educated or very well versed, the children will not speak in English. They used to come and quarrel with the teachers, like, my child will not speak English. What are you teaching? Or how he got these marks and everything. At least one word he did not speak in English in the home and everything what they used to express. Now, when they are taking the class, the students are speaking in English with the teachers. They understood, they are very happy. Madam, we understood that our children know English now.
I think this is a golden opportunity, you know. I mean, the whole obstacle has been converted. In Sanskrit, there is one word called suchakta. Suchakata means even if the obstacle is there, how to convert it as an opportunity.
Opportunity.
Yeah. I really appreciate the way you narrated everything right from the teachers.
Exactly, it became an opportunity, sir. 2 months back, we gave a letter to all the students. They should give willing or non-willing. Either they want to continue in the school or they want to leave the school. They want to take the TC. Somewhere 2-3% of parents gave not willing letter. After this program was implemented, all those parents are also told, we don't want to discontinue your school. We will continue in your school itself. And the care what you are taking about the children, even in lockdown, you are calling us and asking our children, how is your health? Are you washing your hands? Are you eating proper food? And don't do these do's and don'ts, everything you are telling, and then you are taking care more than mother and father. We are very happy. We can't leave you and go. Definitely will continue in your school what they express.
I think this humanitarian aspect is very important, because everyone is trying to jump and prove himself as a professional. But beyond the professionalism, there is a humanism. And that humanism, when it really works, then nothing can be compared with that. And that's what we can see in your personal experience as well. That the whole challenge has been converted as an opportunity. And not only an opportunity, it is a chance. It's a chance for even parents to install such innovative tools and see their students, how they behave, how they talk online. And this is, robust experience, because it happens in the corporate world. That's what we did in Global Classroom. Since many years, I envisioned this, that the time will come for India and for the entire world to connect online. And that's what we were doing, the experience. And today, when we see the dream has been fulfilled, by connecting many schools, many colleges, and many universities are going live now, universities digitally converted, empowered. I think that's a beautiful empowerment chance, I should say. And I'm also very happy with the personal experience. going along with that, I would like to also bring upon the concept like, yes, your school could do that. But when normal schools, Jilla Parishad schools, they may be municipal corporation schools, and even for the colleges or in the urban and rural area, these kind of experiences are not yet even introduced to them. So what do you think in Bengaluru, how many such schools, like how you took this initiative, almost all schools took this one, and what is the percentage? Is it 10% or 20% or 50% or it is just 5%? So what is the efficiency rate as a whole, not as one school?
Sir, nearly 125% of the schools adopted this system and they are doing very well. Uh-huh. And even now government, in Tamil Nadu also, in Karnataka also, they are conducting some classes through television.
Uh-huh.
Television, they are conducting some classes for the high school students. Uh-huh. So they are attending the 9th and 10th class students, they are attending the classes. And even CBSE is also conducting some classes online. Directly they can click on the link and they can connect to whichever class they are, and continuously they are conducting classes. So because this coronavirus is teaching the world how to be, live your life and how to maintain your lifestyle.
Yeah.
Number one. Yeah. And the dreams of our Prime Minister Narendra Modi is happening. I thought it will happen in 5 years. Yeah. Within these 15-20 days, completely this country became digital.
Yeah, yeah. Digital India. I was
digital. It became digital India.
Yeah.
So he is a great leader, and whatever he is praying, it is the universe is directly forcing everyone to do this. Even that note bandi came, lot of black money came out. Yeah. Note bandi forcefully everyone throwed the money also, and lot of change came. There is one point of change came in this particular this thing. And e-learning is having a lot of opportunity in India also, because our country is the youngest country. Yes, many people, 70% is young people in India.
Yeah.
Before, as per my knowledge, before 2018, $1.38 million market is there for e-learning.
Yeah.
And by 2020, it is somewhere around $38 million market happened.
Mm-hmm.
And is another coming, I think, in 2 or 3 years, it is going to reach $100 billion market.
Yeah,
and overall, in the world, nearly $385 billion market is going to extend in all over the world.
Yeah.
So this is going to happen, sir. It will be somewhere cross even to a top post also, because we have highest population and everyone is attached now. Even a fisherman is having is digital now. Fisherman is digital now.
Absolutely.
So during that floods time, that whole Kerala, the fishermen went digital. And now during Corona, everything, the entire nation is digital. In one way, if we take positively, this is
except the spreading of coronavirus, that's the issue. It is spreading from person to person.
Yeah.
Other than that, after Corona came, sir, how many years back we spend with our families for 20 days in home, sir?
Yeah.
Any one of you here in this panel, 20 days spend with your family from morning to evening continuously?
Never been so.
Never.
No Never. One.
We got a chance to spend our time, quality time with our children, with our family members and everyone. And I am very happy, sir, to work like this. We did not stop anything. Even we are doing collection online. We are running our business online. Most of the important businesses are happening. We stopped only, we are purchasing food. Other than that, we are not purchasing anything. Corona came and controlled our expenses also.
Absolutely.
It controlled our expenses.
Eating healthy food at home, sir.
Yes, healthy food and healthy. It is controlling everything. We are
I could run my entire month in just 8,000 rupees.
Yes,
whereas I used to spend 80,000 rupees minimum every month.
Correct.
So in 10%, I can manage very well.
Yes.
That 8,000 is also not for my personal use. It is for, again, the home management.
Mm.
Very
and
nice.
And online courses, lot of courses became very cheap. in this particular time. Very
yes,
cheap.
Sir.
Yeah. 2 lakhs course they are selling for 7,000, 6,000.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And it's a time for us to update ourselves also.
That's what
I also purchased many courses for my children also.
Okay.
For me also, I purchased some courses and I am trying to learn whichever I fail to learn in my life, that kind of courses, which where I have my interest. I am also learning. I am also directing all my friends to take some courses.
I think one of the best discussion that we had. Tamanna, you want to add something in this interesting, very open-hearted discussion? You know, usually we find this is the beauty of an educationist. You know, who doesn't keep anything. He just openly speak with an open heart. That's what matters a lot, actually, in India. Yes, please, Tamanna.
Sir, so far we've been discussing about the role of technology and how it helped our education sector, how online learning has helped not just teachers, but students and even other people related to those being educated, and how peer learning has been affected by it. Now, if we move on to artificial intelligence, sir, the role of artificial intelligence and what it plays in educating the children, would you like to add some light on that?
Yes, madam. See, definitely, there is a scope of artificial intelligence. Future is artificial intelligence.
True.
Future is completely artificial intelligence. So, recently, we are working with some project that will keep one RFID tag in their lace of their shoes. So it will give complete information of that particular person, where he is going, what he is doing, and what is his complete data of that person. Not only that, some companies approached me recently that, see, whatever he do, it will be automatically noted by certain device will be given to the student. Automatically, what is his interest, where he is working, where he is not working. By that, we can tell about every student, like what is his interest and what he is going to be in this in his future. Like he may be an engineer, he may be an advocate, he may be an chartered accountant, or he may be a doctor, or where his interest is going on and everything, we can calculate by using some projects, and we can definitely this artificial intelligence and even what you call machine learning, all these things we need to implement in school level only, not in engineering college, in engineering colleges. We need to implement from school level itself. They should know what is coding and they should know what is logic and everything. From school level only, if they can understand, once they come to college, it will be easy for them. See, in our school, from 6th class onwards, we will teach 11th and 12th. We'll take all the 11th and 12th topics and start in 6th class. In 6th class, what we do is we'll train the PDF, means small problems, definition, formulas from 11th in 6th. 7th, we teach all 12th class PDFs. And 8th, we teach both 11th and 12th advanced PDF. And whatever is there in 9th will continue in 11th. So we'll complete 11th along with 9th. Whatever is there in 10th will continue in 12th. So we'll complete 12th along with 10th. And every week we conduct not subject to objective test for them. So when they are adopting this system, automatically what is happening in the sense their logic is growing. And in when we are doing this schooling and everything, after completing 12th, 1 month, we used to take one crash course and write the competitive examination. That used to work, but now it is not like that. Children are very fast, and a lot of competition is there in this world.
Yeah.
So they need to be trained from 6th class onwards. So in the same way, this coding and everything became tough for all engineering students now. The artificial intelligence means it is becoming fun for them. Machine learning is like a fun for them. They're not taking it seriously. If they take seriously and learn at present, future is that only artificial intelligence and all these things.
Yeah,
so they should learn all these things. And from schooling, if they learn for them, little knowledge will be, if they adopt in school level itself, it will be very easy for them to go ahead in the future. As SAP started with a seed, we should keep seeds in school level itself about this artificial intelligence and machine learning and all this. coding and all this.
Absolutely.
Sir. Thank you very much. I would like to add on this one. What he said is right. In 2005, and I was engaged in a school development program, I took a challenge of introducing C, C++, and also Java, and also HTML, all these new things, what even the youth, not even in the college, they used to learn this. They used to learn after college. So we took directly to the school level, right from the seventh standard, seventh, eighth, ninth. And as he said, in today's context, I did it 15 years before for the C, C++, Java, and HTML. And the result was awesome. The students' magical thoughts, the logical thinking, and getting into it, because they can see the projective results in what happens in the regular subjects. They have to prove it because somewhere it is there and the result is known, and they have to just prove it to prove their marks and prove their intelligence. But when the actual human intelligence comes to prove their logic by applying their logical skills, then the result is completely different. Even Dr. APJ Kalam sir had appreciated a lot this initiative, and we got a national award at that time. And today when we speak, like how he's saying, can we introduce this artificial intelligence kind of things? Because it has both the horizons, one in terms of development and one in terms of implementation. So even in implementation, if we go for education, because anything, when we bring that, any innovation, when it join with education, then it is real fulfillment. Otherwise, till then, it is just like a jazzy world, like emerging trend and everything. But to feel its fulfilled version, like how now the digital version has been really fulfilled by bringing it in the education. Similarly, this artificial intelligence and this blockchains and the new methodologies, new trends, if it comes and plays a role in education, especially for our the child development, mother care, parental, problem solving, everywhere in every area, this can play a magical role. Tamanna.
Yes, sir. That is absolutely true, sir. Sir, I would like to say the onset of online education has also taken us far away from rote learning and cramming and just vomiting out things in exams. It has brought us close to, intellect development and development of IQ, what we read in our textbook, we can apply. I think that is a very beneficial point about online education.
Amy, considering the time.
I think
please take it, because we have to discuss some new things as well.
Can you introduce both of you? I want you to introduce yourself.
Emmy is a fashion designer, sir, and she's working with us now during this corona. We have developed an innovative team here in Pune, and then for doing some research-based development in the education sector, and adding with our, we have a Namaskar with Love Foundation, and Emmy is representing communication and presentation skills. And Tamanna is a law student from Jharkhand, and then she's bringing the legal aspects in digital university, that what kind of legal aspects are there. We are building the entire university online. We have taken up a few projects now, so in that she's contributing.
So I think for Tamanna and myself, the most important takeaways today would be it's a different feeling when you see somebody who's actually practiced all this to, bring it out and communicate to people. There are a lot of theories, a lot of tinted glass philosophies out there. But, when you hear it from somebody who's actually practiced it and brought out a tangible outcome, I think it's great. And that touches and that is understood by us in a very impactful way.
It motivates us and opens our eyes.
Thank you so much for that today. Absolutely. So this would definitely add to our repertoire of knowledge and what we aspire to achieve from this digital platform. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Not only let us not stop here, let us make all the managements understand what is going to happen in the future. Because if the management is not able to understand this, children, yada raja tada praja means whoever is the raja, same like the people will be like that. So even students also will not understand or develop themselves if management may not understand. We can start with we can form a forum and we can conduct one kind of conference, online conference with all the management people.
Yeah, we can host it. Yeah, we can host it.
We can do it very nicely. So with 100 members in the panel.
Yeah, we have 100 numbers and also 1,000 schools registered here even in the initial mode. That's why I called somebody and asked them that can I build their capacity? Because the teachers are free now. Completely they are free. So can we create a capacity building forum for the teachers and even for the college? Good that we have initiated this one. So in the coming days, very soon we'll plan it out. And maybe one of the best working practice that you know you can bring in and we can present it and we'll do it together. Thank you so much.
Sure, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you.